Hi, I'm Jenny from Toolmarks, and today we're going to talk about aesthetic polishing. Before I came to Toolmarks, I worked in mold making for about 11 years, and I had the great luxury of working under some incredible mold polishers. Before I get in depth, I do want to give a huge shout out to Susie, who I worked underneath for a couple years, who taught me some amazing techniques. A lot of you probably already seen the Hacksmith video where they were making real-life lightsabers. I had the great honor of getting to machine that lightsaber and also polish it. So kind of the purpose of polishing is to remove tool marks, and you're basically cross-hatching, you're changing kind of how the metal, the light reflects off the metal. There's a little bit more science involved, but I'm just gonna kind of keep it at that and cover technique. So the first thing you're gonna need are some stones. I like to use my mold maker stones. I start at 220 grit and work all the way up to 1200 grit. You can kind of change up the progression depending on what kind of surface that you are looking for. The next thing you're gonna need is your secret weapon. This actually started out as mineral spirits, clear mineral spirits, and I've turned it into a slurry through the polishing process. And the last part that we're gonna go over today is finally papers. So on this guy, I went up from 500 paper to 1200 paper. The best thing about polishing is you can take it anywhere when you got a nice light piece like this. You can do it out on the patio. I did this at home on the patio, up playing trivia while having a couple beers. It's kind of like knitting, only way better because I suck at knitting. This particular piece, because I was doing it all manually, took roughly about 16 hours because there's a lot of splines and undercuts, and I wanted to get everything just right. And polishing can be a little bit time consuming, but it's incredibly rewarding. All machining processes create tool marks. What we're trying to achieve here is to create an aesthetically pleasing part that looks like it was not machined. So I left the bottom of the lightsaber unpolished. So you can see we have our marks from the end mill, and this is actually raw stock. So you can kind of see the two different unfinished, untouched parts of the lightsaber. Then I went against the grain of the tool marks with 220. Now you have to be really careful with the 220 stone. The 220 stone's incredibly coarse, and all you're trying to do is relieve about 70 to 80% of those tool marks. If you can go too deep, especially with real heavy pressure, and then you start gouging the metal and creating more scratches. So right now we're just evening out those tool marks. You'll notice that I'm doing real small overlapping strokes, and I'm taking my polishing strokes rather lightly. There's a little bit of pressure there, but again, we don't want to gouge the material. For the next stone, we're actually going to go, some people say 45 degrees, I go 90 to 45, but you can see I went the opposite direction. So in this, we did the 220 stone, the 320 stone. This is the 400 stone. You'll notice as we're going up that finish is getting a lot finer. Then we go to 600 stone, 900 stone, and 1200 stone. And then we jump over to papers. And then I did 500 paper, 600 paper, 1000 paper, and 1200 paper. If you take a look at this stone, I actually have it shaped exactly the same radius as the spline. You can shape it with another stone. I actually use the burr on the spline in order to shape this and deburr it and get in this. We're not gonna do a high shine in the spline just because there's really not a whole lot of room, and that's gonna take way too much time. So as you look at this, you can kind of stop at any finish that you want. Some people have desired finish that's a little bit more muted. This is about as high polish as we can get with just stone and paper. Next, we're gonna take this and make it really shine using these. Thanks for watching, and for more tips and tricks, watch our videos here or subscribe to our YouTube channel here.